Today we will make two bases. One will be a putrid pulse, and the other one will be like some kind of dead forest floor, like a swamp. The first I will use some old cork, and then let's fit it somewhere on the base, and so we can leave some, like something like this. So just crack it here. As well, you want to chip this on the other side as well. You want to create some uneven texture. We will use green stuff. Just take a small piece of it, and then we will mix it very well. So it's two components, so you need to squeeze it and mix it until it becomes one solid color. And then after that, we will form small balls. Like make 5-6 different balls in the different sizes. I will use a steel and battle mar to create a nice texture on the top of the stone. After our little balls are dried, just cut them in half using your cutting knife. And using a super glue, we will glue them on the base, just a couple of them, so to create bubbles. I pick up like a few in the different sizes, like one big one, one medium size, and one small one, just to create some nice variety. Now it's time to start painting our base. So I will base the whole base with Zandri dust. You can do this if you have it in a spray or airbrush, you can airbrush it. I just found it like a lot quicker at this moment just to do it with a paintbrush, so I don't need to clean the airbrush later. Just go around, it will take two thin coats just to cover everything, so you want to have a really nice coverage. After our sundry dust is dried, I will use Agrax Earth Shade to shade the whole base. pools itself, I will use a black Templar contrast and I will apply this color two times. So one coat, then after it dries, after like 20 minutes, I will apply another one just on the base around. And as well, you can touch a rim of your stone a little, so it will create a really nice effect. I light the stone. I will use a Screaming Skull, so just dry brush it all over your stone at the top. I pick up this color because Screaming Skull is like a natural highlight for the Xantri Dust. And now I will use a Blackbearer Flash on the base over the Black Templar. Just go one nice coat over it just to have like some nice green finish. After it's dried, I will create another wash, but this time from the Mood Green, and then I will wash the whole pool part of the base again. Just be gentle with this and you will have like a really nice texture all around. And after it's dried, you can do another coat. I found it like nicely in two coats. To create a second base for today, I will use a Stirland Battlemire, and then I will put it on top of the base, but creating a little pool in the middle where I actually want to put my like water effect, like those little like pool with some dead plants or just dead murky water. So just spread it all around and leave it outside to dry for a good like half an hour or maybe even 1 hour. When it's dried, you can paint the whole base in a green color. I choose a Deathvolt green, but you can paint it in any green that you have. Just depends on what brightness of the base you want to achieve. After it's dried, I will shade the whole base with Atonian Gamma Shade. This will be like a very thick coat of it, and then I will properly let it dry for like a half an hour. And to highlight the base, I will dry brush it. I'll use a Stark and Green, but this is up to you, optional as well. Like any bright green color will do the job. And for our little pool, I will use the Wildwood contrast. I will just fill up the hole with the color, just soak it like pretty well, like put a really nice thick coat on top of it. This part is completely optional, because I have this sprue of some metal jungle plants from the Gang's Workshop. This is something very old. I don't know if it's still in production, but you can use any jungle plants that you have by your hand. I will just use the contrast paints, Agaros Dunes and Blackbearer Fresh, and I will just apply it on the sprue and wait for it to dry, and then I will cut it and glue it to my base. Last thing to do is to paint our pool on the base with the art coat, or if you have any other watery effect, you can use it so to create some nice reflection on it. And then after that, just paint the rim of the bases black and your bases are done. I hope I gave you some nice tips about making these bases. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and make a comment below if you'd like to see any other types of bases or any other painting tutorials. That's all for today. Take care and bye bye.